It came up in my ultrasound, and they said that she could die within hours, or she could have a mild version and live a fairly normal life, or anything in between. And they said, we won't know until she's born. It's 1 in 3,000 live births. It has some form of arthrogryposis, and then there's close to 400 different types of arthrogryposis, and that does not include kids like Sarah who are undiagnosed. So they don't know what form she has. It's some genetic form, but it hasn't been discovered yet.
The whole goal of my lab is to design intervention activities and intervention devices that are going to make people more independent and improve their quality of life. The kids that we work with can't lift their arms up against gravity, so their arms are down here all the time. And an exoskeleton is something that you can put on that helps the kids to lift their arms and move against gravity. The really nice thing about, for instance, the exoskeletons is that you can put them on a child and see an immediate change in their ability. This DIY model is one that we've embraced. It's the idea that we can make something and then put out a parts list, materials list, and instructions so that people can access those.
We put it on instantly. Her arm went up for the first time. She can draw, she can feed herself. You know, she can brush her hair. That's huge, and I know it doesn't seem like a big deal to, you know, normal people, but that's huge to be able to lift your hand up and to brush your hair. The more that she moves and the more that she's independent, she's definitely happier. All of that started because she was able to build muscles through that suit. So I don't know where we would be without it. I really don't.